I believe that the best thing a leader can do is lean into their strengths in order to best serve their community. I believe that this is done with passion and authenticity. You can see my authenticity by looking at any interview I've ever done. I've always stayed consistent and true to my beliefs, values, and goals. You can see my passion through various initiatives that I've pursued in AS, such as my I Stand With Ukraine campaign, as well as the subcommittee I created for women surrounding mental health and body image.
Hey there. My name is Andrew Devine, and I'm running to be your next Associated Students President. To me, the most important quality of a leader is the ability to enact real, tangible change. I currently represent over 2,600 gachos as the president of the Student Apartment Community Council, and in the past year have enacted many activities like a silent disco, free cleaning supply distribution, and lots of free food events. To date, I've personally implemented over $90,000 worth of programming events, and I promise I will bring the same effectiveness and vigilance to the AS presidency as I have done in the community presidency.
I think my qualities that make me the best leader are my ability to bring people together and collaborate, and my ability to listen. In all my positions at AS and at various nonprofits, I've brought people together to collaborate. For COC, an example, we had to deliberate and we had to work together. Even though I was in a position of power, it was important to hear everyone out equally. Additionally, as a caseworker in the Attorney General's office, at a lower position in terms of leadership, it was still important and emphasized that all our voices are equal and that we need to work together. And that is the leadership style I want to bring to ASUCSB, bringing people together to the same table, to the same platform, to work together to create better and more positive solutions.
Unfortunately, there are many pressing issues that UCSB students face, such as housing insecurity, food insecurity, and lack of accessibility and resources. As president, I will cover these issues in my platform by ensuring that student fees are spent by students for students, by amplifying student voices at the university level, by creating a website that it displays existing organizations at UCSB, and by continuing initiatives by past presidents to eliminate Saturday exams and express concerns for the creation of Munger Hall.
My platform has five main points. I'll give you the rundown and hope you check out my official statement for more. First, I will enact a UCSB prom, as many gachos who graduated high school in 2020 and 2021 didn't get one due to the COVID-19 pandemic. Second, free liquid IV distribution at all major events like Deltopia. Third, expand the Department of Public Worms to be the Department of Public Worms and Bees to support the repopulation of native flora and native pollinators. Fourth, strengthen our food bank by increasing its budget from $200,000 to $500,000. And fifth, freeze the fees by prioritizing smarter spending rather than fee increases.
The most pressing issues that face our student body are basic needs. To start, we have a housing crisis. Look at CMB and the sweeps and the recent evictions. It demonstrates clearly the problems at hand. We need to work better with our administration and academic senate to ensure that students don't go through this again. Additionally, we have food shortages and food crises. We need to make sure that all students have access to affordable food. That means expanding our SNAPS program to ensure that every student that is available to get that food stamp program needs to be on that food stamp program. Additionally, we need to ensure that all students have equitable access to technology such as iPads, computers, to ensure that their education is fulfilled. That means expanding the five-year plan, setting aside money to ensure we have iPads for rent always, and that students can buy cheaper electronics from us.
I will handle potential backlash from my decisions by sticking to my values, but also listening for ways that I can improve as a leader and recognizing when I've made a mistake. I will always stand for what is right without bowing down to politics. I will minimize the mistakes that I make by consulting with others and using critical thinking and student voices. If there's one thing I've learned, you can't do anything alone.
It's true that Associated Students as a whole has come under criticism this past year over concerns on ineffectiveness and inactivity. As a student leader with a proven record, I pledge to you that in a divine presidency, my office will be active, transparent, and responsive to all concerns.
If I'm elected president, I want my leadership style to be collaborative. That means hearing out everyone's perspective. UCSB is a diverse campus, and I want to hear out everybody's side. So in the case of backlash, I want to sit down both sides, have a conversation, and utilize me and my team to come to the decision about what is our best policy.
I will use my organizational skills and past experiences to balance the roles of student and AS president. I know that my education comes first, but I will always work to represent the needs of students that attend a prestigious and rigorous university. I hope that students will always hold me to the highest standards and accountability while also recognizing my need to balance my time between these two important roles. And as New Zealand's Prime Minister once said, I'm a woman, I can multitask.
Being both a student and a leader does have its challenging moments, so I submit to you that what I've accomplished at UCSB shows the kind of dedication needed to do a good job in office. Thank you for listening, and please vote Andrew Devine for president.
I will be able to balance this responsibility the same way I've balanced and juggled multiple positions within AS and nonprofits since the beginning of my UCSB career.